at Agadir, Fez, Marrakesh, and Ouarzazate, with average temperatures above 70 degrees. Apart from classical Arabic, the language of education, the civil service, and the media, the average language in Morocco is a dialect of Arabic, as well as Berber. Most Moroccans speak French, and many speak Spanish and English. On CACE International's second visit to the Kingdom of Morocco, we took a cultural tourist group. We went over on our third visit to film and chronicle the artwork of Zine Abdellatif, who paints the Gnawan trance of colors and paints to the music of jazz. With Zine, life as art expands to trance art. Zine's trance art explores the mystic ritual of Gnawa. The Gnawan people came to Morocco in the 1500s from Timbuktu with merchants and as slaves for the king. They practice Islam and are known as the Islamic Brotherhood in Morocco. Their music, the mystical music of Islam, blends North African and Arabian melodies with West African polyrhythms and syncopated American funk. In Zine's trance art, color becomes therapeutic, sweetening the convulsion and spasm generated by a delirious trance and giving birth to an absolute serenity. The Gnawa are well known in Morocco for their healing ceremonies, deribibas, on which the colors white, black, green, red, yellow, purple, orange, and blue are worn to enhance the emotion and to attract the particular healing spirit for the individual who dances. Each color has its tempo, and the Gnawa are known as spiritual intermediaries. The complete ceremony includes 7 sections, each controlled by a different saint or family of saints. In the derbiba, a single tune can conjure up a complex set of associations and actions. The saints and spirits each have their own tunes, and a given melody with or without song text is said both to attract the spirit and to indicate its presence. Thus, the performance of a particular tune may be used to summon the saint or spirit who owns that melody. If the music then sends one of the participants into trance, that is taken as proof that the spirit has responded to the summons. In other cases, the spirit may first possess a devotee and then express, through the dancer's mouth, its desire for the appropriate tune. The trance state is hastened by various ceremonial accoutrements demanded by the spirit. The proper combination of spices and incense must be burned, and the dancer must be dressed in the spirit's preferred color.
Ali sayah babati ali sayah
When Zine does trance art, he becomes a participant in the derbiba. He, in semi-trance, paints the setting and the participants, the color of the spirits of the ceremony.
Thank you. L'esprit de Monet à Pipa Bajilali, le maître des lions, enterré à Bagdad. Le noir, esprit de l'Omri ou Omariyine, esprit de la forêt et des matériaux de la nature. Le bleu de Sidi Moussa, Moussaouine, l'esprit des eaux et du ciel. Le rouge ou Damouine, sanguin de Sidi Hamou et l'Allaqia, esprit du sang. Boudrebala, où il y a les différentes couleurs gnaoui pour marquer l'esprit du sage errant. Le vert ou Mgharine de Ait Mrar, qui est l'esprit de la nature. Le rouge, refait surface. Le jaune de la Lamira, esprit de la procréation, de la joie et de la pérennité. Et enfin, une nouvelle fois, le noir pour clôturer. Et cela se poursuit ainsi, sept temps par sept, sans interrompre le tarh, c'est-à-dire la partie. Enfin vient la zammita, ce masque blanc pour les femmes qui ne doivent sous aucun prétexte se dévoiler, sinon leurs visages seront marqués pour la vie. De ces gestes, de cette histoire particulière, de ces sons et de ces couleurs, le transart de Zin est né. Ces ethnométries, qui vont un peu plus loin que les anthropométries de Klein et de la peinture par projection du plasticien le prince Jürgen von Anhalt ou du travail du japonais Aiho, toutes ces données font de lui un artiste créateur à part sur la scène des arts plastiques. Peintre des traditions du Maroc, en mars 1990, il surprit en donnant des empreintes magiques ou transarts. Dans un élan de faire valoir un niveau universel les potentialités marocaines, il a repris dans un sens néo-primitiviste une tradition séculaire voué à la disparition avec le temps. Le corps, tel que pris par Zin dans ses multiples touches, gestes et manifestations, se trouve non comme centre de l'être, mais comme relais, pont reliant le sensible et le tactile au monde occulte et partant au-delà de la perception humaine. C'est cette force, cette synergie qui donne au travail de Zin cette dimension créative d'une sensibilité qui se traduit par la force d'une nouvelle perception culturelle.